But the weather is anything but right now. It's a burner out there today.
Feels like 100 right now in Leesburg, and it's not going to get any better the next couple of days. Let me take you back outside, because earlier today I was up at Stetson University as we carried on a little hurricane expo and got folks acquainted with what to have in their kit and their family preparedness kits, that is. And a great time. A bunch of really, really classy folks up there, and enjoyed my time with you guys today. Outside right now, look at that sky. Got a few Q just starting to build now in and around the four-way corridor. Look at that temperature, 92 degrees. You factor in the humidity, and folks outside right now in Orlando, it feels like 98 degrees. That's one big story for us here across Central Florida. Another potentially developing story is the risk for tornadoes from Iowa into Illinois, including the major metropolitan area of Chicago. Remember, game one of the Stanley Cup Finals begins tonight between the Blackhawks and the Bruins. So we'll have to watch that. We are carrying that game tonight. And there is a very small chance, folks, that if that weather does get going, that that game could be suspended to a later date. So we'll watch that. If anything changes there, we'll let you know. That is that change has not occurred yet, but that's one of the things we're monitoring. West Coast sea breeze, East Coast sea breeze. We've got storms now firing up with the heat of the afternoon. There's Donnell and Rock Springs, a couple of showers and storms here. Back towards the east side of the peninsula, there's the sea breeze. Titusville, we get in real close here for you. South Mare, just west of Titusville. A couple of showers and storms popping on up back to the west of I-95 here over towards Tropical Streak. We do have a couple of showers just south of the beach line. There's the East Coast sea breeze extending southward. A few more storms popping up over towards Keenesville and over towards Bay Lake. So if there's going to be a trouble area later on, Orlando on south, we could see a collision here. Of course, we'll keep you posted on that. Big story today. Look at these temperatures all across the board, the exception being now Brevard County. We are baking 90 to 95 feels like temperatures 101. There's the update now. The villages, that hurts. You really, really need to be careful with that kind of heat. By midnight tonight, no storms, 78 degrees. Your overnight low temperatures tonight ranging from about 70 to 75 degrees. Steady as she goes for this time of the year, that's where we should be. Thursday, west winds, west-southwest winds, sea breeze collision south and east of Orlando. Another hot one with that offshore flow. We are talking about numbers tomorrow. That will be 90 to 95 degrees. Backyard pools will be packed. Rain chances are going to be running at about 20 to 30%. Look at the high in the villages, 94. Claremont, 94 degrees. Back towards Winter Park, 94 degrees. Eastern side of the peninsula, even at the beaches, 90 to 95 degrees. That is some hot stuff there, folks. 7-day forecast. Front to rise on Saturday. Cools us down a little bit in the humidity department by Father's Day, but still not really much of a bargain. Jim and Martha gets us back to normal with the temperature right around 91. A day.